Hello and welcome to this assembly for Monday the 8th of February 2021. As you know, over the last half term I've been thinking about some well-known phrases from the Sermon on the Mount. I'm going to return to that for one last time today. Today's words could be said to sum up the kinds of things that we've been thinking about over the last number of weeks. Turn the other cheek, go the extra mile, don't judge other people, don't harbour anger. Listen to this. So in everything, do to others what you would have them do to you, for this sums up the law and the prophets. Or as it's often paraphrased, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. This is often called the Golden Rule, and it appears in various iterations in philosophical writings and other religions, although often in a negative form. Chinese philosopher Confucius, for example, is credited with saying, do not do to others what you would not wish done to yourself. And a similar rule appeared in ancient Egypt, ancient India, ancient Greece, and ancient Rome. In its negative form, it could be seen as trying not to do anyone any harm. And I suppose that that's not a bad maxim to begin with. We certainly don't want to be destructive in our attitudes to others or cause them hurt, either physical or emotional. If we imagine what would cause us to suffer and then refuse to inflict that on someone else, that's got to be a good thing. But in my opinion, it's much more powerful if we look at it in its positive sense. Rather than keeping our head down and making sure we don't cause offence or hurt or harm, we have to go out of our way to act for the benefit of other people. In other words, it's not passive, it's active. It's very similar in meaning to another well-known phrase, love your neighbour as yourself. Generally speaking, we don't find it too difficult to want the best for ourselves or even for our families. But how far does that extend when we start thinking of other people outside our immediate circle? This involves not only trying to imagine life from their perspective, but actively seeking ways of making things better for them, of improving their lot. You could say that it's about community. If we put ourselves sensitively into the place of another person and wish for that person what we would wish for ourselves or those closest to us, we would never be mean or harsh or cruel. Instead, we would be generous, compassionate, and kind to all those around us. It's also about tolerance and respect for each other. What we're saying here is that each individual is of inestimable worth and is to be valued. Sometimes, when we look at others, we need to imagine a parcel marked fragile. We have to treat each other with care. We have to nurture each other. We have to build each other up. These values of community and respect for each individual are at the heart of what we want to do as a school. Sometimes we talk about them in terms of our school ethos. Let's think about this golden rule and what a difference it would make here in school, but also in our homes and in our community, if we lived by this standard of always doing to others what we would have them do to us. Well, thank you for tuning in to this week's assembly. We've got one more week of remote learning left and then it's half term. I'd encourage you to plan to do something different next week. Obviously you need to stick to the rules, but try to get outside and make sure that you give yourself a break. We've received some more information about awarding of grades at GCSE, AS and A level for the summer, and that's been sent out to your parents. I'll post a separate video for pupils and that will appear on your Google Classrooms later today. Please look out for that. It'll talk about our approach here at Friends and what you can expect over the next number of weeks. In the meantime, I hope that everybody has a good week and enjoy your half term.